Good evening. It's good to see that all of you have come to attend the world premiere of the Audi i7 Sportback here in the Museum of Modern Art, the Pinakothek der Moderne in Munich. In addition, of course, the gentleman from the managing board of Audi AG, welcome. And Walter de Silva is with us this evening. I could add something to his name, I could add a title, but I don't think I need to add anything. Tell us about it, but the head of design, Stefan Zilaf and Wolfgang Ecker.
And the so-called stand. That the stance is all right, that everything is perfect, and whatever the design may look like, it is always to be grounded. And I'd like to do the following. I'm moving up this line upward. It is a very special line for the A7 Sportback, and we know it from the A5 Sportback. It's this special sweeping line, sweeping up, coming from the waistline. And of course, it is one of the specific features of this vehicle. And here, three curves, three, four lines, which emphasize and define the beauty of the A7. You see, we always say that a car is always a beautiful car if you can recognize it.
Let's welcome the CEO of Audi AG, Rupert Stadler. Mr. Stadler, is it correct? Is pride the right word? Is that what you feel now?
Yes, it is a very emotional feeling I have. You see, and you've got the chance to present such a wonderful car. We've worked very hard to produce it. We committed ourselves, and I am sure that this will be a successful car. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you most cordially to the world premiere of the Audi A7 Sportback. Our designers signed the white sheet with their signatures. Mr. Egger and dear Mr. Silav, thank you very much for your short, impressive presentation. We have created this four-door coupe of shows the way ahead. The A7 shows the outstanding design claim of our brand, of our mark, and this extraordinary car, and this is what we believe, car. The A7 is more than just pure beauty. It's got a great, the flagship, the halo car, the A8. And we're going to use it to define a completely new segment, the Sportback of the luxury class. And it is going to charge up our brand even more. And I think it is a wonderful milestone on our way. Wilde once said, one should either be a work of art or wear a work of art. And I should say, you should drive a work of art, definitely. But looking at your faces, then I think our designers really did an outstanding job. And I, and we all at Audi, are utterly in love with this car. And what's so surprising about it is the A7 Sportback is not only the most beautiful four-door coupe worldwide, it's also very practical and it is perfect functionally. Ladies and gentlemen, you can put one or the other golf bag into this car. And this car does not tempt you with its, say, external features only. But we all know the design is the crucial and decisive purchasing criterion for a car. And this is in particular true for a progress, because we believe that the A7 really is a temptation. I'm looking forward to seeing and feeling your response, because in September we are going to have a chance to test drive this car on the road. And I'm sure that you will be thrilled by this car then, as you will be this evening. But first, enjoy this evening, with us, and a handover to Michael Dill. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, from me as well, and of course a nice good evening on the occasion of the world premiere of the A7 Sportback. As was said already, the A7 Sportback is, this is true for the Audi people as well as for me, a dream car. As Mr. Stadler said already, it is a masterpiece of the entire team, the design team, the development team, and also the practice. I think you should really savor this afterwards. But I've made many words, and I can say that you will have a chance to have a close look at this Sportback, see its sporty dynamism even while standing, and also experience and see all its features. Enjoy the A7 from a very close distance, and look forward to experiencing this car at a close range. Thank you very much.
Well, I guess there's one thing that one advantage you have over most of us. You've been to the test track, you drove it. How was it?
Yes, it's always very exciting for an engineer when a car is put into operation, so to speak, when the prototype really drives the first yards or meters on the road. It's as exciting as it is for the designers when a car is shown to the public for the very first time. And we always have a look at all those issues which we try to put into practice, that is all those theoretical issues. We simulated a lot of things and tried to put them into a design, that into our cars. And we compare the prototype with the physical prototypes afterwards, and I can say that there are several revelations. Some of the things really came true, all the things which we anticipated, but on the other hand, there are some things which are not working perfectly. And this, of course, is, say, the salt in the soup. But nevertheless, we hope that we will be able to bring out the design features, and that all these features and technical features will also live up to the expectations of our customers.
And emotionally, how was it?
Well, of course, you use your butt to drive such a car in order to get the best out of this car. For me, it really was a revelation to experience the electromechanical steering in this car. It was a decision to include it, which was not an easy one. That it was all in the decision-making phase, because the axle loads were not controlled very much or very well by the electric systems. But nevertheless, we came up with this decision. I think the result was perfect. We've done something for the efficiency of the car, and this is the car which will be the first car with this steering system, and we are going to use it in other vehicles as well.
So, may I sum it up and say it was sexy, this experience?
I wouldn't have found better words for that.